Hey guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. I'm going to show you how to create this really cute, kind of whimsical, romantic, and feminine updo that's great for wedding season. This is a look I posted on my Instagram and got tons of requests for, so I hope you guys find it really easy to do. First thing we need to do is add texture to her hair so that when we pull it back, it has a lot of movement and it has that kind of ethereal finish. So I'm going to start by spraying her hair with Orbe Dry Texture Spray. This is like the holy grail of texturizing sprays. And especially if your hair is fine or gets flat easily, this helps to build that volume. And then we're gonna go in with a flat iron and make sure that I get a lot of texture at the root so that when I pull her hair back, we see that movement. So I'm just gonna start by taking 1-inch sections. And I'm using the GHD Platinum Plus Styler. This is my go-to flat iron. It's professional quality, and I love that the rounded edges make it really easy to create bends in the hair. Bevel the hair in different directions with the iron as I glide it down so that I get that nice wave pattern. So you can see how that creates kind of a crimped effect in the hair, and I'll continue in this pattern around the whole head. Clamp the iron really close to the root, bevel it, twist it, and drag it down a little. Then I release the iron, and it's already created that kind of buckle or bend in the hair. And right below that, I'm gonna reinsert the iron and then twist it in the opposite direction as I drag it down. And then I release the hair, and I'm just gonna continue in that pattern. So I get almost a crimped-like wave pattern. And then each time that I insert the iron, I'm rotating it up from the root instead of away from the root. And that just makes sure that there's more volume at the base of the hair. So when I get to this area of the crown here, I want to make sure that this has more lift. So I'll insert the iron, twist it up, and then continue in that wave pattern. So now that I've waved her entire head, I'm just gonna choose what pieces in the front I want to leave out, and then we'll pin that away. And I'm gonna use the creaseless clips I have with my collection with Kitsch, and I love these because not only are they cute, they make sure that we don't leave any dents in the hair when we are sectioning. So now that her entire head is waved and I've clipped the hair away, I'm going to use the Wet Brush Smooth and Shine brush to tease the roots and make sure I get a lot of lift at the crown. And also, if you want to see a more in-depth tutorial about how to do these waves, I'm going to post one on my channel, so make sure that you subscribe so that you can be the first to see it. To back brush, I'm just going to section the hair right at the roots where I want to see the lift start, hold it straight up, and then I go in with my brush and I'm just going to gently brush down. So back brushing is not where you're teasing like crazy. I'm just getting a nice little cushion of hair so that when I release it, we have some volume there. I'm just gonna go through in horizontal sections and work down the length of her hair. I'm actually gonna back brush quite a bit down so that when I go in with bobby pins, they have something to hold on to and then the hairstyle is really secure. Now that I've got this nice volume in her hair from back brushing, I'm just gonna go in with a little bit more of the Orbe Dry Texture Spray and spray it at the roots to support that. I'm also going to add a little bit of Fat Boy Perfect Putty. So I'm just using a little bit of the pomade between my palms. And then I'm gonna go in and just massage it at the roots so I get that separation. And I'm just scrunching through the ends so we have additional texture. Gather this back section. And we're gonna secure this first before we pull the rest of her hair back. Take one bobby pin, I put the ridge side against her scalp. I don't open it before I put it in, and I just weave that bobby pin through and then push it in to secure. So now that I've secured her hair, I'm just gonna repeat that with the rest of the hair. And this time we're just gonna secure with an elastic so we've got this nice textured ponytail. So I only put the elastic in and I didn't wrap it twice because I want this to still feel loose and organic, and then we'll secure it with bobby pins. Split this section into two, twist one of them, and twist the other one. Wrap those around each other to create a chignon. Once I have the shape, I go in with French pins and I just push them in and secure. Go ahead and detail this. Whatever I want to see, I'll use French pins to create that shape. So now that we have this shape that we like, I'm just going to go ahead and remove these creaseless clips. And then I'm going to go in with the Tresemme Micro Mist Hairspray and extend for hold. This is just a really lightweight hairspray that won't make the hair feel too stiff or sticky. So I like it for romantic looks because it still has that soft element to it. Before we finish, I just like to go in with my fingers and detail how I want to see these pieces around her face. Sometimes I'll pull a few extra ones back or pull more forward. So you can leave the look as is, but we're also going to go ahead and just show you how to add some curl details to the hair. I love this shape, but we're just going to make it feel a little bit more whimsical and romantic with these pearls. I got these at a craft store. You can get them in strips and they're already sticky, so you can just stick them on the hair and then they come right off. But for a little bit more of a secure finish, I'm going to go ahead and use lash glue and Tweezerman tweezers to just gently place them on the hair. Because this is lash glue, it comes off easily. You can easily pick the pearls off, or you can just wash your hair and they'll easily come out of the hair. Place the glue on a tray with tweezers and the pearls, gently pick them up. And just the tiniest little drop of glue is all that you need for them to stick to the hair. We'll just do a few of these to dress up the look.